In the early years of statehood, Chautauqua was the place to be.
There were hundreds of people, thousands of people sometimes, that attended events at the Chautauqua ground. It was huge. They had people like former President Taft came and talked, Booker T. Washington. There were preachers and musicians and teachers of all sorts that came and presented workshops, and they had concerts, and it was an opportunity to see things that you couldn't see if you were a local person in, 1900.
People would come from Sioux Falls, Minneapolis, Sioux City, Iowa, and they'd catch the train to Madison, and then there was an extra spur railroad that was created to take people directly out to the Chautauqua grounds.
Chautauqua was a traveling education and entertainment event that connected citizens across the nation to a shared lineup of popular entertainers and authors and politicians and thought leaders.
So Miss Minna Mae Lewis, June 28th to July 10th, children's entertainer, reader, and lecturer, is exceptionally well qualified to meet the demands of the Chautauqua audiences, which are everywhere becoming more critical and demanding higher class attractions. Walden, magician and illusionist. The engagement of Mr. Walden, the great magician, on the Chautauqua program for July 5th, 6th, and 7th promises a change from the regular routine. He proposes to rest our emotional senses and rouse the faculty of forthcoming the mysterious. He also promises to please the fascinate the eye with beautiful creations and magic. I think it helped bring the country together after the Civil War. The ideas, it made South Dakota, it pulled us into the national thought process. I think we were experiencing what other communities were experiencing and understood.
The Lake County Museum where Brew works houses one of the largest collections of Chautauqua artifacts. And it's where volunteer Denise Lewis has donated hundreds of hours researching and cataloging the Lake Madison Chautauqua collection of programs, flyers, meal coupons, and photographs.
Chautauqua exposed the community, every community that it existed in. It exposed people to things they wouldn't get to see otherwise. Because if you put yourself back in that era, there was no internet, there was no ability to get educated online. There was no ability to watch a concert online.
While most host communities put up temporary, circus-like tents for Chautauqua, the Chautauqua grounds at Lake Madison were home to permanent Chautauqua structures, a 2,500-seat auditorium, grand hotel, and swimming pavilion. Chautauqua attendees took full advantage of all Lake Madison had to offer.
There was lots of recreation. People would, same thing they do today at the lake. They fish, they boat, they get out on the water, they swim. They had slides and swim platforms built. They had a boathouse built. There was canoes and rowboats to rent. There were leisure cruise boats that would, steam-powered boats that would take you out on a scenic cruise of the lake.
So where is Chautauqua?
Denise Lewis became interested in Chautauqua because she grew up on Lake Madison, and her childhood home sits across the lake from where the Chautauqua grounds once stood. And even though the last Chautauqua was held in 1931, and the event's permanent structures were long ago replaced by modern homes, Lewis feels strongly about the lasting impact Chautauqua had on the community of Madison.
It's a significant part of our local history, and people may or may not realize that it spurred our growth, and Madison has prospered ever since, really. That it was a historic movement in the country, and this happened to be the location of one of the most successful in the Midwest.